So how did you go about vetting sentiment data sources and ultimately choosing one for your research?
Yeah, that's a great question, and I think that's the question that everyone has to start with when they're starting to tackle big data, because just like the name suggests, there's a lot of it out there. So our search really started with firstly just trying to compile a list of everything that's out there and available, and that list is pretty long now, as most of you know. So slide 5 here just gives you a flavor for the type of data sets that are kind of out there in this universe now. We actually started with a list of about 850 individual data sets that were under consideration. To give you a flavor for what those look like, obviously the topic we're talking about today is kind of news and social media sentiment. There's a large number of data vendors in that space now. Satellite data, very popular these days in terms of buzz, at least. It even featured in an episode of Billions. That's basically taking photos from space and, you know, counting the cars in people's parking lots and that kind of thing. Geolocation, a little bit controversial these days, but tracking, you know, where people walk on with their cell phones. Did they go into, you know, a Best Buy or whatever. Web data, kind of a grab bag for anything you can scrape from the web. Credit card data, obviously transaction data from people's credit cards, trying to predict what they're buying and that kind of thing. So there's an awful lot of data out there. And so our job, like everyone else who dabbles in this space, is basically kind of a needle in a haystack problem, right? We've got to narrow down this list of data sets and try to find ones that are applicable to what we're doing, which is ultimately trying to forecast long-term stock returns. So the search process for us is kind of multifaceted. I think the first thing that we thought about was just trying to target the low-hanging fruit first. And what I mean by that is basically looking for data sets that have a reasonable history behind them, that have reasonable breadth, i.e. cover a large part of the stock universe that we're interested in, have some kind of structure to them so that the mapping issue is not prohibitive, i.e. you know, linking the data back to an individual stock identifier or ticker, and so forth. Because there's so many data sets out there, you've got to start somewhere, and I think it makes sense to start with the more obvious ones, and certainly the social and media sentiment fit that bill. Certainly, RavenPack, for example, has a pretty long history built up now. In our own work, we've so far tested about 24 databases. This just gives you a flavor for the type of things we've looked at. Obviously, the topic today is the right-hand side of that. We've did a pretty extensive body of research on news and social media data vendors. We ultimately tested 9 of those, and RavenPack was one of the ones that we selected in that space.
This is RavenPack.